Me, Earl, and the Dying Girl is a coming-of-age book written by Jesse Anders, who also adapted it for the screen, which was released at Sundance on January 25, 2015. The story centers around three teenagers who deal with death for the first time in their lives. The camera follows around the leading character, Greg, who is forced by his mother to visit a girl called Rachel, a girl in his school who has been diagnosed with leukemia. Rachel at first does not accept his pity, but Greg convinces her to just hang out with him for just one day so that his mom could get off his back and she will never have to see him again. Greg, however, keeps going back to visit her at her home, and the two of them engage in conversations from family relationships to the difference between them as individuals going through the never-ending halls of high school. Greg is not the everyday popular kid of high school, and neither is he the bullied kind. Greg prefers to remain in his own circle as a means of avoiding any trouble. He also refers to everyone around him as an acquaintance, especially his childhood friend, Earl. Cancer plus teenagers plus boy meets girl story equals a touching romantic story.
But this isn't a touching romantic story.
Me, Earl, and the Dying Girl instead is released with the caption reading, "A little friendship never killed anyone." The first half of the film is dealt with humor because the idea of friendship and death is something that neither of the characters understand. But then the drama builds up when it is seen that Rachel's disease is possibly a reality.
I'm so tired of you treating this girl like she a burden. Because somebody actually cares about you, her life is over after this.
Life can keep unfolding itself to you just as long as you pay attention to it.
It was the best of times. Worst of times.
It's so much harder than I thought it would be.
It was life.
This is Rana Hasan on 360 TV.